be a combined speech. And I've instructed the timer to do timing for the green light to go in 12 minutes, amber 13, and the red for 14. Because our speakers today will be our president, Megan Gallagher, and our vice president of education, David Schiff. And Dave and Megan may be their first time as officers, but they're very passionate about our Toastmaster Club. Whether it's through Megan's complicated relationship with Santa or David's fat acronym for our club, they definitely think they are creative. While that might be a questionable conclusion, one thing is not. They are committed to the success of our club. And today, they want to share their vision for the year under their leadership through a less offensive acronym than David's previous one. It's RPD, our year in a glance. Please give me, help me give them a warm welcome to the lectern. David and Megan.
First letter of that is R, recruit. As an organization, if we're not growing, we're stagnant. Also to quote John Beter, last John Beter quote, promise. Better beats best. So what that means is that we might be at our best level, we need to be better than that. We need to continuously grow and expand as a group. Toastmasters is an untapped resource for a majority of the company and a majority of the entire neighborhood. It's a resource where people can come in here and they can have an open forum to participate and improve their own public speaking skills. And we need to be able to recruit them and help them understand the opportunity at hand. So let's say you're at the card shop for some reason. Hey Megan, how's it going? You buying some cards?
Oh, hey David. Yeah, I spend way too much money here. I love cards.
Do you know what time it is?
Yeah, it's like 11:40.
Oh, I gotta get running. I gotta head to Toastmasters.
Oh, I heard about that group. I've heard some mixed things about Toastmasters.
Mixed things? Must have been from Brandon. What's up?
Yeah, well, I mean, it's really cool. Like, that's an awesome thing. I just heard, like, you guys have to go every week, and it's, like, this big weekly commitment and stuff. I just don't know if I'm gonna do that.
Well, I mean, it's an hour a week, once a week, and it's just something during your lunch hour on site. It's really not bad.
Well, I also did hear, like, everyone's really good. Like, it's a speaking club, and I really don't like speaking in front of people. I freak out and get really nervous and I start sweating. So, like, I don't really know. Like, that's probably not for me.
Well, I mean, you can always get a different deodorant. But also, we have everything from novice to expert and everything in between. It's a great place where we have every skill level evaluating every skill level. So it's great because you get somebody who is amazing at it, evaluating your first speech. You get somebody who is new to it evaluating your last speech. It's all about the balance and getting all different perspectives.
Okay, that makes sense. I mean, I guess I could go to improve myself, but I did hear also that you guys like criticize each other, and there's like this thing where people count all of your odds and ends and like all of your filler words of like. I say like a lot. And I don't know, like I heard you do that first speech and someone comes up and evaluates you after. I don't know if I want everyone hearing what I did wrong.
That's only to Brandon. And actually, it's something where it's very, very light evaluation. It's something we'd like to take the sandwich approach, actually. We go positive, feedback, and positive. And it's all about your own personal comfort level with it, too. The whole point is to basically improve you. to your best of your ability. And so it's something where you go, you don't get a grade, you don't get anything of that sort. It's just very low pressure and very much just things you can focus on to improve yourself each time.
Okay. Well, I guess that doesn't sound that bad then.
Okay, so you'll come.
Let me know. Contact me next week and maybe I'll think about it.
All right. Chalk one up to the guest list.
So this is a scenario that David and I feel like we've been in a lot. And sometimes we might not know exactly how to respond to everyone's differing personality that is going to join Toastmasters. So we really want you to kind of think through the people in your life that might really benefit from being in Toastmasters. You know, take out a list after this and write down like 5 people that you might want to recruit this year and consider why and how in those, even these scenarios or other things that you know about them might be a good way to get them to join. Again, we benefit from everyone being here and we're really excited to help others grow and we grow from that. So we encourage you to take these little steps, whether it's even in volunteering to walk with them to the meeting if you're in the building here at American Greetings, or sending them a calendar reminder every week, or messaging them, or emailing your friend that you know is in town for the week and you just want to show them what Toastmasters is so they can get involved back at home. There are so many options, and we really just ask you to open your mind and figure out how you're personally going to recruit this year.
Thank you. And that actually brings us to our second letter, P, participate. So we can recruit the entire organization. We can recruit everybody in the world, but if they don't participate, it doesn't mean anything. So we want to make sure that everyone in here is coming to the best of their ability and who is signing up for roles and expanding their own horizons. And one thing that we've noticed with this is people aren't really sure of how to sign up. We've actually seen examples such as this. Like, let's say we're at the card shop 1 month later. Okay, and buying more cards, I see?
No, you always see me here. But at least now I make time to come to Toastmasters. I'm so glad I joined. It's really been awesome.
Yeah, you've been great. You know, the only thing is, I've noticed you haven't really signed up for any roles lately.
I really did mean to. And I've been watching everyone. I feel like I've learned a lot, but I'm just not really sure. You guys have this weird, like, online system that you're implementing, and I'm super confused, and I just don't even understand. So maybe it's just like walk us through it or something, I think that you would get a lot more participation.
And see, this will never happen again. We're going to walk through the steps today. Everybody is familiar, and if you're not, be familiar, with our home screen. 8142.toastmastersclubs.org. If you could, please make sure you favorite this or bookmark it so it's available at a click. This is our lovely up-to-date photo.
Which we're going to get.
Which we will definitely get updated. And so let's say you want to log in and sign up for a role. So you go right here. And for this scenario, you want to sign in as David Schiff for some reason. So you would type in your name here in the system. Make sure your password is what it was initially. I believe when you first sign up, it'll give you a temporary password. You put that in, and then you assign a new one. One thing that I've heard and that I've noticed myself, on Internet Explorer, do not hit enter after typing this in. Move your cursor to right here and click this button. As weird as that sounds, if you hit enter, you'll get this red error message, and it'll just log you out. Not sure if it's something with Internet Explorer or the platform. It's something. Don't do it. So you hit authenticate/login. And then you're logged in. You're logged in as David Schiff. And so you want to go and sign up for the particular meeting that you're at. So you want to go to Meeting Agendas, and that'll bring you over to the agenda screen. For this scenario, we're going to log in for the August 4th meeting. This is a precursor to this meeting. And let's say I wanted to give a speech. So I would just scroll down to August 4th, and then the agenda for August 4th would populate right here. It would list everyone who has a role and every role that's still available. All we need to do at this point is just click on the role we want. If it's available, hit sign up, you're signed up. For a speech, there's one additional step. So you would hit sign up, and my name is associated with that now. And then just to clarify, I would select what manual, what speech I'm doing it from. I put in a title, And then potentially, I would put my speech introduction right here. And then I would hit update speech, and everything would be right there. Another really, really useful tool is if you're Toastmaster for the day, you want to send out those pesky emails, which are so important to make sure that everybody is signing up, but everybody in here might be a little visual. Great tool to send out to the entire group. You hit this little button right here, it'll send an email to the entire group with your personal message and the agenda. So this right here, this entire box will show up in the email with who signed up for what and what roles are still available. So rather than just saying, we need a ballot counter, we need a new speaker, we need a general evaluator, things like that, you can say that, but then you can show that too. So we can get to the both sides of our audience to make sure that everybody is aware of what's going on.
A really other awesome thing about our website is that we can have other people come serve other Toastmaster clubs, and one of ours, AG, would pop up. Now, for me, when I first joined, I kind of wanted to see who's in the club, what's going on, and we only had about 3 people that had profiles on here. Somehow, we have a couple more now, but we still don't represent what our full American Greetings Toastmasters Club is. I think that Audrey did a really great job at showing what we would love everyone to do for their profile on our AG website. She noted what position she had, or like Kim put, member. So note what your position is, and then you would also just give a little brief segue about yourself, saying, you know, Audrey noted what her goals are, what she wants to do, and what she's doing in Toastmasters. If you're more of a goofy person, even more than that, Brandon, you can just put out there, you know, you like to do this or this and that. Add a fun fact about yourself, or, you know, if you have a really amazing accomplishment, like Anand, he received a promotion due to like the effort that he had in Toastmasters. So having that on there, I love how he also has his LinkedIn page and his YouTube channel up there. These are things that can be really interactive and help us find out more about each other, as well as outside people that are thinking about joining our club. So please go on and fill out your profile. I will be extending mine like Audrey's, and I hope that all of you will too.
And one additional note, this also benefits the Toastmaster. So for example, if you were calling out John Katrasak, you would know that he's a CCCL. And so on the agenda, when the Toastmaster is up here just running down the list, they might forget that John is a CCCL and not give him this title. You want to make sure that we're calling attention to the titles and that we're recognizing everybody's achievements. Which actually brings us to the third letter. Participate. Oop, that does not bring us to the third level.
What did you expect from participating, and what will you get back after this? So there are some monthly emails that are going to be coming from David. You know, just to remind you to sign up for that upcoming month and also the Toastmaster assignments. We decided to leave this up to you to participate in all of the other roles, but we would like for the Toastmasters to be assigned so that we have some structure moving forward and we're not jumbling from week to week. So for each month, the Toastmaster will be assigned. That Toastmaster is responsible then for that week to send out, preferably as far out for the week as possible, an email like David had shown in the slide, to send out that email listing the roles where people can easily just click, sign up, and it takes you straight to the website. Once you do sign up, which I encourage you with that monthly email that David sends out, go ahead and fill out for the month. Look, am I going to be here for the next 4 weeks? What are the roles that I need to fulfill my CL, and how can I do that? Sign up as quick as you can. I mean, other people might take those roles, and that might be 1 week further away from you getting your CL. So help yourself out, improve yourself, and do that month to month. Say you do find out, you know, oh, I have a presentation from work that I can't come the 3rd week of this month, and you did sign up for a role. That's totally okay, but don't just go on the website and unclick your name and act like no one's ever going to see it again, and you won't show up, and you didn't sign up because it's not on the website anymore. So, we will know because we did send it out, but also just do your part, and just like before with signing up for roles, just find a filler person to take over, and then everything will work out smoothly for that week.
Which actually does bring us to our third letter. Develop. D. And so, back to the whole thing, if we don't recognize our individual achievements, if we don't recognize our club's achievements, if we don't encourage everybody to pursue better than they are and to continue to improve, then we as a club fail. The whole goal is to make sure that we're developing and we're improving. And so we want to do this through recognition, mentors, and also through some new tools that Megan's going to talk about in a few minutes. Recognition. As a club, we want to continue to be recognized as a distinguished club. We've had the amazing record of getting that going on and on year after year, and we want to keep that going. And the only way that we can do that is if every individual is making sure that they keep up and that they are recognized for their CC, for their CL, for any sort of accomplishment that they want to achieve, which, by the way, is at their own pace. That's the great thing, back to earlier. It's all at your own pace. You can take a year, you can take 10 years, as long as you're working towards your own goals. And to help everybody achieve that, we want to make sure that the mentor program is fully, fully developed. I will also be asking once again anybody who wants to be a mentor to be added into my pool. I know I've got you in my pool. And to make sure that we match up mentors and new members and make sure that we harbor a good relationship and that we harbor a learning relationship where they can both reach out to each other at any time and improve each other's speaking abilities. And now Megan's going to talk about a couple of the new tools that we're going to be showing today.
Thank you, David. So Toastmasters has given us so many awesome tools to work with. And today we're going to start with three. There'll be several coming out throughout the year, but there's three that we wanted to implement right away. And the first are folders. So we would like our guests to come in and walk away with something tangible. So we have created folders that have basic information about Toastmasters, as well as some of the things coming up that I'll share with you, that basically outline what we stand for, what the tracks are, what the certificates are that we want to do, and how we can, you know, benefit them from joining our organization. We also felt that, you know, why wouldn't you want to keep all of your Toastmaster things in the same place? I know I do. So I think that having member folders is really important as well. We are going to be passing out member folders after this, and it actually contains the same things that guests have right now. And you can fill it with the rest of your stuff, keep your CC, CL, or other manuals that you're working on in there, and have that to put in any miscellaneous items throughout our time at Toastmasters. Our second thing that we will be doing are individual meeting trackers. I know I'm definitely a list person, but I'm also someone that wants to track my progress. And that's something we're going to be focusing on here with developing ourselves. This is a self-improvement group, so we want to see how we can remember what we did week to week. As members, we try to come as much as possible, and the weeks are blending together, and it's like last week was left-handed day, and what was tomorrow? So how can we remember what we did? I think this is a great tool. You'll have just your name. What role did I fill on that certain day? Did you participate in table topics? What did you talk about? Did you win the ribbon? What did I even say? I can't even remember sometimes. So how long did I speak for? What were my ahs and ums? What are those filler words that I use every time? What do you want to improve on next time, and what did I learn this meeting? For example, last week I learned a lot of things about left-handed people that I would have loved to write down. So this week we'll be able to do that. I think that this is an awesome tool that will also help you realize what are those things that you can work on. So if you week to week start noticing, I didn't hit the time for speaking. Okay, well, maybe that's the thing that you can improve on next time and really focus on. Or you said so 50 times while you're up at table topics for 1 minute. Maybe I should try to cut so out of my words when I'm standing up here. I think this will really highlight what you can grow in and what aspect you can work on and focus on. So we're very excited about this. This is actually a tool that we're going to have the greeter hand out at the beginning of each meeting. And again, this is optional. This isn't required. This is for your own development and something that we feel can help you. So you can slide it in on that folder when you walk out of the door and have that for reference for Toastmasters forever. Our other thing that we are going to be handing out in our folders are our goals for this year. And I'm really excited about this worksheet because I feel like it asks the right questions for you to grow and develop. So how do you describe your current level as speaking? You know, what level are you at as a leader and where would you like to go with that? What specific skills do you want to focus on? Maybe it's all of them, maybe it's just one of them. You know, what would you like to achieve this year, and what suggestions do you have to the club that you could bring to one of the officers that could really make a difference? We're really excited about this. Again, it's for your own personal benefit. We're not going to be collecting it or holding you to it or punishing you if you don't get to it. But we again think it's a great way to help yourself develop and question yourself on where you're at and where you'd like to be. So with all of this great information, what are some ways that you can get involved now and what can you do now? So go ahead, give your next speech, Audrey. I know you're up next, so we're looking forward to that. Go ahead and do it. You know, something that I always struggled with was I felt like I had to just over-prepare and be perfect, and just coming up and giving your speech, and you'll learn so much from that. So don't hold back. Just give your speech, and you'll receive really great feedback. Take on a new role. I think that the point of having that tool to be able to sign up is that someone's not randomly putting you in a role. You get to choose that. You get to decide where you want to put your effort for this meeting. So take advantage of that. Look what you need to get your CL and work towards it. You're here every single time if you come as a member, then you might as well get credit for participating and getting involved. We do have our upcoming fall speech contest. I know I mentioned this before, and I would love to encourage anyone to step up and be involved in our humorous or table topics contest. There's also a lot of roles you can fill within that, so that would be great. And I do believe that being contest master is so, so encouraging and really something that helped open my eyes to what Toastmasters even was all about. So if you're completely new, don't know anything about the contest, I encourage you to, of course, attend, pay attention, take on a role, and maybe even talk to me about how you could possibly lead in the spring. Last but not least, if you are so invigorated that you're like, this is awesome, I'm going to be president next year, I'm so pumped. Well, start thinking about in your folder, you'll have a list of all the officer opportunities. And we encourage you to kind of think about maybe where you would fall. And if this is something that you would want to do next year, then let us know. And we can kind of talk to you about how you can get there and work on that.
Well, so today we took a look at our year at a glance through RPD, recruit, participate, and develop. However, these three things individually don't actually add up. The overall goal is to make sure that we offer an environment which provides the best opportunity for every single individual in here to become the best speaker they can. As Megan mentioned in her opening, it's all about first and last impressions. Toastmasters gives you the opportunity to capitalize on both. So the real question is, what will you do this year, Mr. Toastmaster?